Good day. In this video, I'm going to be talking about how to utilize the virtual inputs in the UAD console so you can send sound from your DAW or from the Mac's internal sound into the console and then manipulate it. There's a couple of main reasons why you would want to do this. The first one is that you might want to do headphone cues, or secondly, you might want to put effects on the two-mix of your DAW output that are UAD plugins. You want to listen in real time with low latency, for example, or a virtual instrument. You want to play with UAD effects with low latency, that kind of thing. So there's a number of different places we have to go in the computer to get it all up and running. So I'm going to start at the end of the chain, which is just getting the virtual instruments to be accessible. And it's in the UAD console settings. So I'm there now under hardware. And at the very bottom, we've got this channel DSP pairing part where you've got DSP pairs and virtual channels. So we need to make sure that there are virtual channels, that there's like a number here. I'm using 4. You can actually get more than that. You can get 8 virtual channels, but I'm using 4. I've got a stereo pair out of Logic, my DAW, and then a stereo pair out of my Mac's internal sounds. So once we have that accessible, we can go to different places. So we can go to the DAW or to the Mac's sound. So I'm going to start with the Mac's sound, which is in audio MIDI setup, and that is accessible through the utilities folder in the Mac's apps. So it defaults here to MIDI Studio, but what we want to look at is the audio devices. Yeah, so audio devices, and then if you click configure speakers, you get this cool looking 3D room. And you can see I've selected mine to virtual 3 and 4. I think it will default to like monitor left and right, but this is set to virtual 3 and 4. So this means that the sound from my Mac's internal sound effects or music that's playing from YouTube or something is gonna go into the virtual inputs on the UAD console, and then I can manipulate them. So the next place we're going to go is in Logic. So for example, Logic, we'll go to the settings and then audio. Okay, so I just figured out that because I'm using screen capture and I'm using loopback to get the sound from Logic into OBS to record the sound with the screen, it's making it so the virtual output is, or virtual inputs on the console are not showing in Logic. But if it was working, they would be right here. And then you would select them and then it would work. Yeah, so that was the other thing that I wanted to show you, was the headphone cues. So basically, along the channels here, I've got Q1 is the one that's set up to go to my actual headphones in the booth. So this cool little section down here, which they've recently changed from the old version, if you see Q1, Q2, and Q3, those are different possible headphone mixes. So right now it's set to the main mix, like whatever the overall sound is coming out of the computer, like YouTube and anything would go to the headphones. But if I was actually recording somebody using the microphone in the booth, I click this mix so it's not selected, and now it just says Q1 to headphone 1. And that means that anything that's turned up along this line of cues here, let's see if I can zoom in. So like for example, that, you know, that are turned up, and these are the outputs of like Logic, because we want the backing track to be able to sing along to. Studio Q is turned up here, which is my talkback mic. The mic itself, the LCT440, it's turned up. The SM81, which is my acoustic guitar mic, it's turned up. So all of those things are feeding to the headphones, but not coming through the studio monitors. And that's the important thing, is I can, have somebody hear me in the talkback mic, but the talkback mic's not gonna feed back in the control room with me. So that is basically the overview of this. I hope that helps. If you had any questions, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.